Right, scalpel. Are you looking at me, guy?
We're losing adrenaline now.
You'll never amount to anything, Pat.
Everybody clear. You scum.
We've lost him.
Welcome to Games Master, the show that firmly believes life begins with a comfortable, snug-fitting pant. Since you saw us last, the Angels and I have been helping underprivileged children. But now that we have Alpine Racer and the brand spanking new Tekken 2 arcade machine here, we've vowed never to help the poor again. So excited are we by today's event, which we are calling Cracking Blokes. Arcade beat-em-ups don't come with instructions. Apart from the basic punch and kick moves, they guard their secrets more closely than an overbearing auntie. So it's up to the players to discover the special moves, combos and secret characters. Most of us discover a handful of these before going to the pub, but some people take the whole thing a lot more seriously. When Tall Bloke Saul, Not So Tall Bloke Mo and Averagely Tall Bloke Louie come across a new arcade machine, they get to work. Not in a fast food place or a small bank, but trying to discover every single move, character and combo.
We are Games Crackers. We're going to crack a game with the least amount of money possible.
We stay a step ahead by being up to date, by working in a team.
Yes, that's the whole idea. Organisation is the key to Games Cracking.
And the first step in this toply organised jaunt-type situation is a visit to a Japanese bookstore in darkest North London.
£8.40, serious money. That's why we have to make sure we get the best magazine for the job. This magazine's got everything you need. Secret options, power moves, combos. Only problem is, it's in Japanese.
Don't worry, Mo. Ask that shop bloke to help you out.
Mr. Kito, could you explain this move, please?
Akira move, forward punch.
Two forward punch?
Yeah.
Meanwhile, Louis has popped down to his local internet cafe for a swift half of that information orgy that is the internet. Louis quite literally logs on and launches a search application that pulls in the relevant material. These are web pages, mines of information created by crackers like Louis all over the world. He saves all this information onto disk and he's away, probably doing a runner without paying. Each cracker has their own wee secret book where they record all their information. Everything from a simple two-button block to a 40-button combo requiring split-second timing. Ooh.
This is my notebook, you know what I mean? Get all the moves then, notebook. It's just, my memory ain't too brilliant, so I have to have my little notebook with me and my little, you know, just note it down as it happens.
Solmo and Louis discuss tactics, have a rare old time, then head off to the arcades to test it out.
Well, what you've got initially is the semicircle on the joystick, punch, and then the giant swing comes out.
So we decided to find out just how hard Saul, Mo and Louis really are by giving them the most difficult beat-em-up to date, Tekken 2, newly arrived in this country. For once they'd be working not as a team, but competing against each other without the aid of magazines or internet searches to find out which of them is the ultimate top cracker bloke. And here are the three fine crackers who will be delivering the goods tonight. We have Louis, Mo and Saul. Louis, on average, how long does it take you to uncover the special moves in a new game?
Well, you're looking at maybe to half an hour to an hour. You'll come across maybe like a handful of the moves in Tekken.
So quite quick, really?
Not necessarily. If you've never played it before, it will be quite technically a challenge, but otherwise, yes.
Talking of technically challenging, Mo, do you think Tekken 2 is going to be a problem for you?
Well, for us, it's not really a problem because we're top games crackers, but for the ordinary guy in the street, it's going to pose a lot of problems.
That's because he doesn't have a fine pair of goggles.
No.
That's why.
You need the goggles.
So, Saul, tell us, why are you all in dungarees kind of things?
For all the heavy-duty games playing, really, I suppose.
That's a fine answer. OK, if you'd all like to get cracking then, Lewis, if you'd like to step up first. We will feel free anytime, guys.
Right.
Go up there. OK,
right,
thank
now.
You. We've got there in the end. We'll go over to Games Master then and find out exactly how the Golden Joystick winner will be decided.
At the end of the show, each contestant will reveal the three most spectacular moves they've uncovered. I will look at each contestant's findings in turn and award the joystick accordingly. May the best man win.
So the crackers have started, and helping to explain exactly what they're doing is Games Master's very own arcade expert, Derek Lynch from Funland. Derek, welcome.
Thank you.
Now, Derek, how are they going to be working through this then?
Well, first of all, they'll try some of the moves and combos that they know from previous games and different button tricks and so on, and hopefully they'll get some moves out.
Now, I see, Derek, that while one of the guys is playing, the other two are looking at his hands and things like that. I know they usually work as a team, but what are they doing that for tonight?
Well, in this case, because it's competition, they're trying to steal moves off each other.
Right, so watching exactly what button combinations
that
the other guys
do.
Okay, well, if we look at the screen just now, we see that that they're playing away and just trying to find their feet, kind of, you know, try those little move combinations from before.
That's right. So Louis is probably trying some of the moves that he knows from previous games and seeing if the move comes out by accident.
Okay, then. Well, we'll leave the guys trying to find out the special moves and we'll take a look at what's happening around the world game-wise in today's news. If, like blokes called Tarquin, for example, you have a PC but no friends to play with, Mr. Help is firmly at hand, with BT starting a network gaming service next year. Simply connect your PC to Wireplay, choose your opponents from up to 3,000 other people logged on, and you're off, so to speak. There's no registration, all you need is a copy of any Wireplay-compatible game, and the Wireplay software will be distributed free. It's the usual phone calls charged at standard rate type situation, so friendless folk unite. You have nothing to lose but time you could spend going out and meeting real people. Once again, other shows are left far behind mumbling we're not funny or clever, because these are exclusive pictures from Japan of the new arcade sensation there, Speed King. This large ungainly object recreates lunch-losing drops, caustic curves, and even 360-degree spins. One Speed King arrives in the UK in January, boasting a choice of two cars, mild and hard motion options, four tracks, and undoubtedly the fastest gameplay ever. It's also the most expensive arcade game ever, costing 115 grand, so even I can't buy it. Until next week, anyway. And now, news for blokes who like alien films. A special four-minute alien movie is the latest experience in American motion theatre rights.
I don't believe I'm going back.
There's no Sigourney Weaver, but the £2 million movie does boast loads of cheesy special effects and some of the worst acting we've ever seen. Welcome back. Our crackers have only been going for a few minutes, but already they've uncovered some exceptionally competent special moves. Derek, talk us through the ones we've seen.
Well, here we have Mo using the character Nina. He's going to show us an excellent example of a combo arm break. One break, two break, gets the other arm, three breaks.
Ouch! Oh, very painful. What you can see in the replay there. She doesn't muck about, this girl, does she?
Right. Grabs both arms.
And that's it. Nothing left but to fall to the floor. Okay, who's this then?
Okay, we have Sol here using pull. The kick there and there, straight into a leg counter. Catching the leg, he's it, straight into the ground.
Fantastic. Turning defense into attack.
That's right.
And finally, we have something that Louis has managed to come up with.
Right. Louis using Bayek, thundering like leg strike.
That was, and a gentle chop between the legs, just That's for good right. measure there, Derek. Okay, then, I'm sure we've got a fantastic amount of special moves still to be uncovered on this fine show, but I can wait no longer for today's celebrity challenge, so let's go over to Games Master to find out what it is.
We are sending our next contestant out on the piste on the sensational arcade experience, Alpine Racer. Finding themselves atop a virtually vertical ski run, they'll have the crystally clear task of skiing their way to the resort at the bottom before the clock runs out. What they must do is pass through the gates, as each one navigated will give them an extra second. Crucial if they're going to reach the glass of sparkling wine I've got waiting for them at the bottom.
And on the piste with us today, please welcome the best reason to watch Don't Forget Your Toothbrush, Jadine Duran.
Welcome to the show, Jadine.
I'm feeling fantastic at this point in time, Jadine, because
I'm sorry, I have to say, you're probably the most beautiful woman I've ever seen in my entire life.
And you're the most beautiful man I've ever seen in my entire life.
Listen, don't, because I'm just going to lose the plot completely here. But I believe, was that not too forward of me to say that? Is that all right?
No, that's absolutely fine.
I've got to grab every chance I get, Judy. Do you know what I mean? I'm not, you know, I don't hang back.
No, sorry.
I've completely forgot what I was going to say now. Oh, yes, I was going to ask you, have you ever been on a skiing holiday before?
Never in my life, no.
So this is the first time for you?
Yep.
On the piste. What's your perfect holiday then, your dream holiday?
My perfect holiday would have to be the Caribbean.
What would you like to be doing during the
jet skiing, full Monte, lovely.
Could I come with you?
Yeah, you're quite welcome if you want to pay.
Well, I would pay a fantastic amount of money, Janine. Honestly, yeah, I'd sell the house, I'd sell my kids, I'd do the whole lot, do you know what I mean?
Well, when should we go then?
Okay, well, we're going to take a short break now while I call up the travel agents. In the background, we've still got the crackers going on. We'll have Jadine on the piste after the break. Welcome back. Today's special guest, Jadine Duran, is just about to try Alpine Racer. And, of course, under Scottish law, Jadine and I are technically boyfriend and girlfriend now. Helping me co-commentate, backed by popular demand, is Kirk Ewan. Kirk, this is going to be a tough challenge. What tips can you offer Jadine?
Well, the main thing Jadine should be looking for here is to go through as many gates as possible, Dominic. She gets an extra second for every gate she goes through. And the other thing is to use her natural rhythm to the best possible advantage.
Not too much extreme movements?
No, that's right. If she keeps the movements down to as minimal as possible, heads for the gates.
OK, thanks very much, Kirk. Best of luck then, Jadine. Jadine has to finish the course within the time limit. Off you go. And off goes Jadine. At the top left-hand corner of the screen, you can see how much far down the course she's progressing. That's where the little yellow pointer arrow is. She's at the top just now. And you can see the time in the top right-hand corner as well. Above that, you can see the amount of flags she's gone through compared to the amount of flags she has missed. She's doing fantastically well so far, Kirk.
She has started well, yeah. She's getting all the flags so far. But, I mean, it's going to be slightly more difficult when she gets further down the course as she starts getting some of these leaping jumps to keep the whole thing going.
OK, at the moment, we can see she's got 48, 47 seconds left. Of course, every time she does go through a flag, this will go up the time by 1 second each time. Again, if you look at the map in the top, we can see about a quarter of the way down the course. Kirk, still doing well.
She is doing well, and I must say, it's a fantastically attractive outfit she's got on for this particular skiing challenge. I mean, that is really a very...
Is it a red or a mauve, Kirk?
I would say it's more of a pink, Dominic. Okay. More of a pink.
All right, then, 33 seconds left, about coming up to halfway down the course. She's only missed one flag, Kirk, so far.
Well, I'd say this is certainly a good run. I mean, if she can just keep up the pressure, she'll make it all the way down.
OK, coming out with a bit of a tight right-hander coming up here. This is going to be tough. Is she going to go on the barrier? No, just whistles past the barrier. There we go. Oh, smack, bang. Well, she's up in the air. She's back down again. That's going to cost us some time, Kirk.
It certainly will. I mean, she's looking like a bit of a crippled crow when she hit the air there, but she's managed to pull herself back onto course. And if she can just pull through these last few flags under the bridge here, she'll probably, maybe make it.
OK, then, like I say, we've got about one-fifth of the course to go. There's about 11 seconds left now. She basically cannot afford to miss a gate. Missed one gate there, 8 seconds left. We can see the end in sight though, Kirk. She might just do this.
I'm worried about her progress, but there is a small, very small chance that she'll pull it off.
This is it, one more gate to go through. 3, 2, she's got to go through this gate. 1-0 now, if she can get to the finishing line before it stops. She's through the finishing line, Jadine has got the challenge. Jadine, absolutely fantastic.
Thank you.
Was there any point at all where you were getting a little bit worried, thinking it was getting a bit hairy?
The trees come at me a little bit too fast, yeah. But I pulled it through, made it, got through that flag.
That was fantastic. The only other thing is, though, I noticed when you were playing, I know what you said about us going on holiday,
yeah.
But I noticed you've got a ring on the third finger of your left hand.
It's my dad's. Oh,
so you're not actually,
no,
so you're not engaged?
I'm young, free and single.
You are? So yeah. I have still pulled?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, that is absolutely fantastic.
Lovely.
Then it's with enormous relish that we present the Games Master Golden Joystick to Jadine. Another round of applause for our special guest tonight, Jadine Duran. While I quickly get my bags packed then, let's go over to Derek to find out how the crackers are doing. How's it going, Derek?
Well, you see here, Sol has discovered Lay's special powerhouse move. Watch carefully. On one leg, straight over the top, full energy. Person takes right out. Here, you see Louis using Nina is going to do a leg breaker. Over the top, onto the ground, snaps with the leg. Also, you'll see Nina do a python. Gets her energy up. Splash! And there you go. Here you see Mo has discovered Yoshimitsu's 10-hit combo. kicks. Oh, I finish off with the amazing sword slash there, right through the centre. And back to you, Dominic.
Thanks very much, Derek. Okay, guys, sorry that took me so long. Just saying goodbye to Jadeen. I'm sure you can understand. It was a long, lingering one. Sol, how much money then would you have to spend finding out special moves like this?
Well, you need definitely a pocket full of change to play this game.
Are we talking about more than 20 quid, less than 20
quid? Yeah.
About 20 quid.
Yeah.
And so, Lewis, obviously, we're nearing the end of this. Do you think you can come up with a special juicy one before we run out of time?
Well, yes, we've managed to find some 3D surprises there for you, and I'm quite sure that you'll find it entertaining.
Okay, well, I certainly hope I do, Lewis. If I don't, then you're going to be in trouble. I might even give you a bit of a kicking. Who knows? okay, then, like I said, I don't have much time left, but while they get those last couple of special moves out, we'll take a look at today's reviews.
First up, the best-looking football thing since that Lady and the Manageress, Goldstorm on the Sony PlayStation.
It's got everything. It's got the animation, it's got little flick-ups, it's got overhead kicks, it's got free kicks, penalties, and some amazing swooping around the pitch effects.
My only quibble with what is the PlayStation's first football game is with the sound. The music's a little bit mundane at the moment, and also the players sound like they're walking on packets of Walker's crisps.
I think the sound's okay. This is the definitive console football game. It's brilliant. It kicks victory goal, the Sega Saturn alternative, right out of the ballpark.
Now, the Mario gang return on the Super NES to make Jimmy Nintendo another bundle of yen in Yoshi's Island.
The main difference from previous Mario games is that you're now controlling Yoshi, and Yoshi moves very differently to the old Mario sprite. He doesn't jump quite as well, and he has a long tongue he can use to grab things like flowers and various pickups along the way, which he then turns into a stone or an egg to fire at the enemies. This takes some mastering.
There are six worlds in Yoshi's Island, and on each world there are 10 levels. And although it seems very small in comparison to other Mario games, it's actually such a tough game that it really doesn't matter.
Does the world, after all this time, after Donkey Kong, do Nintendo owners need another Mario game? I think they do. I think there's always room for another Mario game.
Because Rick and Dave don't get out much, we're letting them go to the pictures to see one of the most fantastic-looking ladies I've ever married, Sandra Bullock, in The Net, which opens on October the 6th, and it's about a happy hacker whose identity is deleted when she gets involved in an evil corporation's sinister multinational dirty tricks-type situation.
Well, you have been virus, Mr. DePina, and not so very nice one.
You are the best. I knew I could count on you. So what should we do?
Well, don't think about hitting the escape key on any of your systems for a while. One keystroke will wipe out your whole system.
God, I don't know how these things happen. You know, I just ordered that security program last week. What's it called? Gatekeeper?
Well, that's what they all say. Did you install it?
Absolutely, the minute we got it, I think.
Not to worry, everything's under control. It's gonna be okay.
You're the best, Angela. Now, do you think we'll be able to get this back in stores by week's end?
Absolutely. Everything but the virus. A friend of mine collects them. I don't know, some people say string.
You are a genius, Angela. I can't thank you enough.
I kind of wonder. It tells the story of a young woman who has her whole identity changed on the internet when hackers get into the FBI's mainframe and they steal her identity. They change her name, they take her house, they take her national insurance details, everything. But really, it's a very dire movie. Sandra Bullock is probably the only interesting character in it, and without the presence of a really nasty bad guy, it all takes a little too long to unfold.
As it was, it turned out to be a very, very tepid version of Pelican Brief with computers instead. Mind you, the computer literacy is quite good. The very fact that occasionally a virus happens, although they have given it that Hollywood effect. A virus happens by dissolving the screen. Very bizarre that. It doesn't really happen in real life.
Yeah, the internet is fine on a one-to-one basis, but as far as making a Hollywood movie out of it, I don't think so. It's all just a little bit too boring.
Someone that can help you. Give us the disc, Angela.
You have the wrong person. I don't know what you're talking about.
Angela, we're not
offering an option here. Just give us the disc and we'll give you your life back.
I don't understand. I don't have your disc. I don't know what you mean.
Give us the disc, Angela.
Right, we've stopped the crackers and we've been recording their games playing throughout the show. They have selected the three best moves that they liked. And now Derek and I are going to talk you through them, starting off with Lewis. Now, Lewis is playing Baek here. What's he doing, Derek?
That's right. Here you see that Louis has discovered Baek's three-hit flying kick combo.
Fantastic.
Called the Hunting Hawk.
Next up, we have Jack.
That's right. Here you see Louis discovered Jack's Timber Smasher and then finishes off with double-fisted clout to the ground.
That's fantastic.
Amazing.
She tries to stop him, but he doesn't want anything to do with it. Okay, finally, he's playing as Nina.
With Nina, now you want to see, like the school scrap, slaps on the ground.
Fantastic slapping face action there. Now we're going to move on to Sol's three moves, starting off with one on Lei. Derek.
Here you see Lei starts what was discovered. Sweep and then straight up into a spinning sweep at the top.
Right when he was in the middle air. Didn't even give him time to land there.
Excellent.
Okay, Sol's second move on Paul.
Right, Paul, 10-hit combo. Watch for it. Bam, bam, bam. Excellent.
Two and
there you go.
In there. I lost count. Okay, finally, on Lei again.
Okay, Lei again. Triple somersault kick. Three.
Very athletic there. And finish it off with a little smack to the groin there. Okay, some fine combinations and special moves from Sol. Finally, let's see how Mo did. And Mo starting off with King.
Here you see Mo has discovered King's leg locks. Totally amazing. Twisting round.
That's a lot of twists for one leg to handle, Derek. We can see it in the replay.
Incredible.
Ouch. Okay, Mo's second move is again with King.
King, that's right. Five throw combo.
I can't believe it.
Amazing. One. Two. Three. Four. And spinning around. Five.
That is unbelievable. And he's still got one to go after this. This is his final special move, again with King.
That's right, it's called the surfboard. You have to see it to believe it. Leg lock, picks the arms, straight up, surfboard.
Ooh. So why did they call that a surfboard, Derek?
Well, he looks like he's surfing, but upside down. Maybe riding the crest of a rave.
All right, fair enough. I'm sure there are people who surfboard upside down. Okay, that was Mo's moves. Now it's over to Gamesmaster for his adjudication.
For his ability to find the most complex, the most stomach-churning, the most humiliating spectrum of moves, including King's sensational five-throw combo, the joystick must surely go to the one and only Magnificent Mo! Incredible.
So Mo is the winner. That means basically that Lewis and Sol aren't. Lewis, why didn't you win?
Well, trying to get out the surfboard move was pretty difficult. Basically, the main man won.
He certainly did. And Sol, your reason for why Mo's were better than yours?
Boy.
It's in there somewhere. I know you have a great excuse, Sol.
It was his lucky day, wasn't it, really?
No.
Was it just luck, Mo?
No, it's the magic goggles helped me out a bit.
It was the goggles. I thought, when I noticed that at the start, they were a fine piece of headgear and indeed a classic piece of eyewear as well.
Yes.
And they saw you safely through.
Yep.
Well, congratulations, Mo, for all three years. It was a fantastic display, and make no bones about it. But there can only be one winner, and the special Cracking Brokes Games Master Golden Joystick goes to Mo. So let's have another round of applause for our three crackers, Lewis, Mo, and Sol. And that is the final piece of action from today's show, because we have to go now. Just remember, life is like a pair of ski pants. If you've got a fantastic body, it's terrific. If not, then you can't hide the saggy bits. Bye-bye.